reading Wait No Paint by Bruce Watley. Once upon a time, there were three little pigs. They lived together in an old house on the top of a tall hill, along with 73 other little pigs, which is why they decided to leave home and build their own little houses. The first little pig built his house out of straw. The second little pig built his house out of sticks. The third little pig built his house out of bricks. Bricks would keep out the wind, the rain, and the big bad wolf. The first little pig had just finished building his house when he heard a splash. "Oops," said a voice from nowhere in particular. "I spilt my juice." "Yuck," said the first little pig. Now his new straw house was soggy and sticky. Squish, 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 came a wet knocking on the door. It was the big bad wolf. "Let me in, let me in," he growled. "Not by the hair of my chinny chin chin," squealed the pig. "Then I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in," said the wolf. But before the wolf could do anything, the house collapsed with a wet plop, and the little pig took off as fast as little piggy legs could carry him. The second little pig had just finished building his house when the first little pig came running up. "There's a wolf after me," he gasped. "Did he huff and puff and blow your house in?" asked the second little pig. "He didn't have time. Someone spilt juice on my house and it fell down all by itself," said the first pig. "Well, it looks like he's coming to finish the job here," said the second little pig. The wolf was almost at the house. They slammed the door just in time. "Ow!" howled the wolf. The door had slammed right in his face, but he was still hungry. "Get me in, get me in," he began, clutching his nose. "Or I'll yuff and I'll nuff and..." "Wait, I've got to redo the nose," interrupted a voice from nowhere in particular. While the wolf was getting his nose fixed, the two little pigs ran out the back door. The third little pig was enjoying a good book and a glass of pink lemonade when the two little pigs burst through his front door. They told him about the spilt juice, the wolf with the hurt nose, and the mysterious voice. The third little pig jumped up and bolted the door. "I know who the voice is," he said, turning white as a ghost. "It's the illustrator." "Yes, it's me. I'm the one who is painting this story," said the voice, who was indeed the illustrator. "I'm sorry to tell you, but I just ran out of red paint. Without it, I can't make you pink. That's why you've all turned pale." The first pig felt so faint, he had to sit down. The third little pig was not happy. "This is embarrassing," he said. "We have to have some sort of colour." Suddenly, the three little pigs felt queasy, like they were riding on a boat on stormy seas. They looked at one another and gasped. They were green. Green all over. "Green? You made us green?" cried the third little pig. "You don't like it?" said the illustrator. The three little pigs shook their green heads. "Well, I'll try and think of something else, but be careful," the illustrator continued. "The wolf's coming." The wolf was, in fact, right at the door. "Let me in, let me in," he howled. All this running around was making him hungry. He didn't care what colour the pigs were, as long as he could gobble them up. "No, not by the green hair and a green chinny chin chin," said the pigs. "Well, I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll..." "How is this?" interrupted the illustrator. The wolf peeked through the window and howled with laughter. The illustrator had made the third little pig patterned. "This is not funny," said the third little pig to the illustrator. "Now I'm blending into the furniture." "You see," when he said when the first pig sat on him, "I'm starting to feel like a real clown." Suddenly the third little pig looked like a clown. "Uh-oh," said the first little pig. "I think the illustrator misunderstood you." The second little pig explained to the illustrator that the third little pig had said he felt like a clown, not that he wanted to look like one. "Oops," said the illustrator, and he made the third little pig pale again. On the other side of the door, the wolf was still hungry, so he huffed and he puffed some more, but he just couldn't blow the house in. So he decided to climb down the chimney instead. The three little pigs heard the wolf on the roof. "Quick, let's build a fire," said the third little pig. "That will keep him out." They put more and more wood on the fire so it would get red hot and... "Wait, no paint," said the second little pig. "No red paint." No red paint meant no fire. No fire meant the wolf will come down the chimney and gobble them up. "Look," shouted the third little pig to the illustrator. "Because you ran out of red paint, the wolf is about to eat us up. Do something quick. We don't want to be in this story anymore." Once upon a time, there were three bears, a mama bear, a papa bear, and a little baby bear. the end.
That's great.